Now, let's go back to the vision that I shared with you about the flag of Great Britain and a hand tearing it. You remember that? Whose hand tore the flag? Tell me, everybody. The Lord's hand? Am I right? Okay. Now listen. Till this moment, when the Lord spoke all these things, I was of the same opinion as you all are, until what the Lord said next. He said, "Behold, the devil is seeking to tear this nation apart." So whose hand? Not the Lord's hand. It was the hand of the devil that tore the flag into two. "Behold, the devil is seeking to tear this nation apart from fulfilling her destiny because of Brexit." So it is the absolute will of God that Britain comes out of the EU. That is the will of God.
Yes. Yes.
You must be cut off the umbilical cord that has held you for all this while. The time has now come for the umbilical cord and the soul ties to be cut, because it has bounded you and kept you from entering into your destiny. It has kept you bounded all these years. Now, the devil has spoken lies over this nation for the last 3 years. What are the lies that your lawmakers are telling you? Oh, if Britain gets out of EU, anarchy will break out in the land. Chaos, discontentment, lies have been planned to unleash against this nation to tear into the Union Jack. These are all lies. When the year 1999 came, a lot of economists and world leaders began to say that when the year 2000 begins, all the clocks will go haywire. Do you remember?
Yes.
So all the economists, all the world leaders, the scientists, computer engineers began to be doomsday prophets. And when the preachers and the leaders of the church heard all that, they jumped on the bandwagon and they began to preach on that. They wrote books and they sold millions of books and made tons of money. So the whole world was living in fear all throughout the year 1999. The months passed by, and when December came, everybody was filled or anointed with the spirit of fear. So I took it up because my own staff came and told me, "Oh, let's do some safeguard. Okay, if this system breaks down, what are we going to do? Let's have all our mailing lists handwritten, so that if the computers fail, at least we have all in a hard copy." So I went and prayed. I asked the Lord, "Lord, what is going to happen? What should we do?" The Lord very simply told me, "It will just pass as an ordinary day. Just pass as an ordinary day. Yet, everybody was so full of fear on 31st December 1999, and they were waiting anxiously for the clock. Tick, 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 tick. And then the clock showed 12:59:59. They all hold on to their hearts. Boom! 1 o'clock. Or 11:59:59. No explosion. No explosion. And the clock just went 00001. January 1, 2000. Everything worked very well. But look at the tons of money everybody made. In the same manner, you have been told lies that anarchy will break out, chaos will break out, Discontentment will break out because of this, because of that law, this law changed, that law changed. These are lies that have been planned to be unleashed upon this nation, and the end goal is the nation to be torn apart into two. Scotland will break away. See, that's another threat. And then Northern Ireland breaks away and becomes one Ireland. And what do you have? No more Great Britain, just Britain. Or just England. This is the plan of the devil. Amen. The plan of the devil. And we have one more day to stop all this from happening. So tonight, we are going to pray for one more time. And from tonight till we meet again tomorrow morning, you please continue in prayer. Till the evening of tomorrow, we don't stop praying. We must contend for our faith. Amen. Now on the 25th of June 2016, we had a prophetic conference in London, and I saw a vision. In the vision, I saw four mighty angels of the United Kingdom come to the meeting. And when I look at these four angels, I was told they represented the four regions of the United Kingdom: England, Wales, Scotland, and Ireland. Ireland is supposed to be one, not two. That is not how it's supposed to be. It's supposed to be one and part of England. That's how today, that's how God sees. We may have international borders or demarcation lines. They said, okay, this is no more Great Britain, this is Great Britain, but that's not how God sees. So in your heart, when you pray, you should pray like that. So these four regions are the integral part of United Kingdom, the Union Jack. Now, the 13th of October, as I was flying, coming to the United Kingdom, at 7 in the morning, I was suddenly moved by the presence of God that came and flooded the seat on which I was sitting. I was still on the plane, and I looked at the clock on the TV monitor. It showed 2 hours 08 minutes to reach Manchester. It was at that moment the presence of God flooded my room, this area in the plane, and I saw a vision. In the vision, I saw the Lord Jesus Christ in the heavens. And he said to me, come, walk with me. And the next moment, I was translated in the heavenly realm. And we began to walk on a narrow path. And as we were walking, beyond, I saw a glorious city. It was so bright. It was shining with light and glory. And as I was looking at this glorious city, suddenly, it became engulfed in total darkness. The city, the sky over it was all in total darkness. And I was in a shock looking at this. And then, as suddenly as darkness came, a light broke out in the center. And the light became larger and larger and filled and cleared the darkness away. And as I was looking, the Lord Jesus now spoke. He said, this is how United Kingdom has become. Once upon a time, it was full of brightness, full of light, and then it has become dark. Your present state, full of darkness, but a light will break out. A light will break out. Okay, please listen carefully, because these are all pointers for you to pray. my light will break out, but she, Queen Elizabeth II, has the power to do it. So she is God's woman, standing as a representative before God in this nation. She must not compromise, but stand up for righteousness. She is born for such a time as this, as Queen Esther. You know, that is the reason why she's still alive. Because she has a very important work to do. After she does that, then she will be taken home. Until that work is done, she will still be sitting on the throne. And God will preserve her long life. She's in good health, right? Every time I see pictures of her, she's full of smiles. I like her. I first saw her when I was 10 years old. She came to our country. And I was standing very close to her. And I waved her bye. So I have very fond memory of seeing the very young Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II. She was very young. Now if you minus 40 years back, she was slim and very young and very, very compassionate, very gracious. I don't think I've seen another monarchy or queen like her. Very gracious. Am I right, everybody? Very gracious, very loving, very kind-hearted, and very compassionate woman. She is born for such a time as this, like how Queen Esther was born. She, Queen Elizabeth, must be bold. As much as she is kind-hearted, as much as she is tender, at this crucial period of history, she must be bold. So we must pray that she will be bold. She must not give her consent for UK to remain in the EU. That's number one. Or for corruption to grow and breed in the UK. She must not do that. She has already done the first part. She has sided with Boris Johnson's government and given her consent for Brexit. Am I right, everybody? But no one should twist her arm and then make her go back and not give her approval. So this is what you need to contend. Secondly, pray that she will stand strong against corruption from growing and breeding in the UK. Corruption not only meaning money, but also morality. The corruption of morality, evil in the land, wrong laws being passed in the land. Like about 5 years ago, when same-sex marriage bill was passed in the United Kingdom. See, ultimately it goes to the Queen to make her final, to put her final signature. Although she's constitutional, she still has the right not to sign. So you must pray that she will be bold and not give a consent. So when the Lord said that, I know a little bit about monarchy, laws governing monarchy. So I told the Lord, Lord, but the monarchy is just ceremonial and not executive. And then the Lord said, yes, but she has the power. What power? A power called royal prerogative. She can use that power, which she can use if she will speak out. The people will listen. Because of the great love that all Britons and even the Scots have for the Queen, If she will speak out, the people will listen. If she comes out publicly and makes a statement, this is right, this is wrong. Let us go towards righteousness. If she says that, all the Britons will listen. And then I dig up some history and I found that there was a precedent in the British history of such a thing taking place. During the time of Queen Victoria, she had done that. Although the British monarchy is constitutional monarchy, there was one time Queen Victoria had attempted privately to influence government policy and ministerial appointments. And the Prime Minister and the government had listened to what she said and acceded to her request. So it is possible. Now the other thing that is very important is we must pray that Queen Elizabeth must not appoint Prince Charles as the next heir to England. This is not the will of God for him to come on the throne. If he ever comes, it will be similar to what I told you earlier. You have a gay lesbian minister and filth coming from there to flood the whole nation. Even though it is constitutional, it is recognized as the hit. So if the hit is filthy, then filth will flow, that will flood the whole nation. So Queen Elizabeth must not appoint Prince Charles as the next heir to the England's throne. So when the Lord mentioned this, I reminded him of another incident. One of my very good minister friend, a very, very dear personal friend of mine, a prophet of God who went home to be with the Lord a few months, just about last month, Prophet Neville Johnson. How many of you know him? Now, many of you may not know what I'm going to share with you now, because he had always kept some of his personal spiritual experiences and encounters private. But once he had shared this privately in a meeting, therefore, I can share that with you. So one day, about 5 or 7 years ago, maybe not seven, at least 5 years ago, he was praying in his living room in Brisbane, Australia. An angel appeared before him and said, "Come, let's go." The next moment, he found himself in Buckingham Palace, right in the Queen's bedroom. He was not there in the spirit, he was there in the flesh. And when the Queen saw him, she was shocked and she shouted, "How did you come here?" And Brother Neville was shocked himself. How did he come here? He was shocked. And just as she was about to raise the alarm for the security to come, he stopped and he said, "I am a prophet of God, sent by God with a message for you." And she calmed down. And she asked him, "What is the word of the Lord?" See, that showed that she is a very godly woman. Am I right? Yes. I know from revelation from the Lord that in the line of kings in England, there were two very godly queens, Queen Victoria, Queen Elizabeth. So he then told her, "Thus says the Lord, you shall not appoint Prince Charles as the next king of England." So to which the queen said, "But how can that be? That is against protocol. And that's unconstitutional. It is proper and constitutional according to the legacy of the monarchy that I am bounden by law and tradition to appoint Charles." But again he affirmed, said, "No, you must not do that. And the next moment, he was brought back to his living room in Australia. So the message was delivered. And I reminded the Lord this incident. I said, Lord, when this has already happened, how can then the Queen not appoint Prince Charles, which will be unconstitutional? Now, this is what the Lord told me. There has been a precedent in the history of Britain where such a thing has happened, where it was jumped. A next in line heir was not appointed and jumped to another person. This has happened in history. Therefore, is it true?
Yes.
See, I know nothing about all this. So therefore, the Queen can do it. And she should do it. So she must boldly take the right decision for a godly seat to remain on the throne, for the UK to be blessed and prosper. For this nation to be blessed spiritually and to prosper materialistically, you must also have the right person on the throne. So in conclusion, let him who has ears to hear, to understand, dress himself in a warrior's garb and go into the heavenlies to wage war against the evil plans of the devil. Now it has been made known to you what are the plans of the devil. So what should you do? Put on the armor of God. Ephesians chapter 6 verse 11. And go into the heavenlies to war against the principalities, the powers, the spiritual wickedness in high places for the destiny of the United Kingdom.